She said, how come you never take off your ties? I said, because you never take off your lies. Wake up, you're fine. You just need to make up your mind. She says, I get that you're the poet here, but allow me to break down my makeup philosophy. You see, I wear it because being plain old black and white is just means I'm colorless, and those two extremes are just too extreme for me. So why don't you, Mr. Poet, tell me something philosophical about looks? I told her, look, if it's philosophy you want, you should really be about books. But okay, I'll bite. To me, it seems pretty apparent that to you, colorless really means transparent. And your fear is that it's more than a disdain for being plain, but then in color, you seem to find a cloak for your pain. She says nothing to object, but she allows me to stand there and witness her process. So she's standing there, and she allows me to witness her standing at the foundation of the sculpture that she's making to base herself on it. A little embarrassed that I can see all this, she brushes her cheeks with blushes. She's sweet, but even in this, somehow she lacks honesty because her blush is paradoxically a permanent shade of 12-hour modesty. And then she's unburdening herself of the burdens that she keeps in the bags under her eyes, and they shadow like they're hiding the light of her soul behind thunderous skies. And then her mascara helps her to ignore the mass scarring of her soul. And then she grabs that pencil and lines them up to that ideal image in her mind she struck. And then off the top of her head, she's retelling her tale, but it's just starring the highlights. Her red lips stick together as though joined in agreement that they'll never spill the secret of who she really is. She forgot the concealer, but at this point, she doesn't really see the need. Nearly ready to leave, but now like she's looking for lost change, she starts rummaging through her brassiere like she's looking for leverage against the world. And she settles on a cleavage, thinking the idea most strange that someone might cleave to her without it. So that even while her push-up bra buoys her mammary glands, my memory hands me images of a time when she was as simple to read as black ink on white paper. A picture whose texture had a uniform feel, but she's pushed up far beyond me on her platform heels. She's done. She's made up a fairy tale. And this construct of her imagination says, tell me I'm beautiful. To which I say, if the eyes are the window to the soul, then I am a disappointed peeping Tom, because I was keeping warm off the heat that yours generates like a supernova's best, and I return to tell you that you, ma'am, you, with your slightly colored contact lenses, have a soul which is just slightly overdressed. But you're beautiful, and have been so from the beginning. Not the first time a man told you how deep his desire was to hold you, but the beginning. Not when you first spirited from prepubescence to adolescence and time chose you to feed new essence, but the very beginning. When you, and I know that it's odd, my dear, but it goes back to when you were truer than Athena springing from Zeus's head. You were God's idea. Your spirit, the mind you taint, and the body you paint. A prime example of his penmanship, a poem pitted to parade his workmanship. And as you go through the motions from fetal position to fatal position, your entire biography was written with his flawless calligraphy. So wake up, you're fine. You only need to make up your mind. And she says to me, so you're saying I should take it off? I say, no, by all means keep it on, I like the colors. I'm saying that the human vessel is inherently imperfect, so that maybe she's born with it, but you need to take care. Love the skin you're in, because you're worth it. By all means, as long as the option is open and the potion is potent, sip slow. But as the years make their marks, don't let it break your heart. Just say amen to the omens. But if you insist on battling these seven signs of aging, please remember that time lining your face is only serving as evidence to make your story more worth the paging. The crow's feet and laughter lines and the nature of a human being. And they only serve as evidence that you have lived, that you have dreamed, that you have been. You want me to tell you you're beautiful? I wish you knew that there were no words to add to or take from it. That you're amazing with or without the mask. So what's your problem with it? She asks. It's not the makeup I mind. It's just that many who wear it are blind to the fact that that which has the power to attract lies not in the face, but the makeup of the mind.
Yeah.
You see, beauty is an altar before which we all go. But as you approach it, bring small sacrifices. Change your face, but don't alter your ego. And maybe when you wake up, you'll find that the only thing that needed to make up was your mind.